Well, I've been farming this place since 77 when I got out of Cornell. That was just after the Delaware and Hudson tore up half the tracks between Binghamton and Albany. You see, their real estate taxes were based on how many tracks were on a parcel of right-of-way, and with modern switching and controls, they do without double tracks in most areas. Now they just have a few places where eastbound and westbound can pass each other. My farm's here in the middle, on a single track. A train always seems to come along when I want to go to my fields on the other side, and I have to sit and wait. I've always been interested in what's on the trains: lumber, aluminum ingots, coal, propane, chemicals, and I've tried to guess where they're going. So I've been watching the trains for 35 years, but just a couple years ago I saw something I couldn't figure out. They started running these big enclosed car carriers, you know, for automobiles going out to the dealers to be sold. But the strange thing was, a lot of them were empty in both directions. Empties east, empties west, back and forth every day, always at least 10 in a stretch, and always right behind the locomotive. Then I noticed they were never in trains with dangerous freight, like liquid propane or industrial chemicals. And they were always in trains probably headed to the West Coast. Lots of overseas shipping containers and J.B. Hunt piggybacks. I just couldn't figure it out. Why run empty cars in both directions? Why put them in the safest part of the string? Why segregate them from other types of freight? I had the TV on last spring, watching the disaster in Fukushima, and they were saying that we have identical plants right here in the Northeast. But no one seemed to be making much of a fuss about it, or if they were, the press wasn't giving them any coverage. And that's when the little light in my head finally lit up. Those westbound car carriers aren't empty. They're hauling spent nuclear fuel rods out to Nevada, to the Yucca Mountain Repository. Now, before you get your knickers in a twist about the feds abandoning that project, just stop and think. If you were going to open the facility and start shipping nuclear waste all over the continent, would you advertise the fact? Wouldn't it be safer from terrorists and protesters and lunatics if you just did it on the slide? Hell, we did the entire Manhattan Project on the slide. I figured there was only one way to find out for sure, so I ordered up a Geiger counter and set it up between the rails and, well, you heard the buzz. They're running red-hot nuclear cargo through little villages and big cities all across the country. Just how long do you think it's going to be before we catch up with the Russians and the Japanese? We have our own little circles on the map. Sometimes it just sucks to be right. Now what the hell are we gonna do?